In the previous movie, we cleaned up our script and created a panic state for the humans. In this movie, we'll finish off the simulation by creating a user interface for setting up the scene. Open the scene, Zombie Apocalypse, Part 6 Start. Until now, before every test, we've had to repeatedly remove all our characters and change the number of humans and zombies via their variables in our initialization script. We can make this a bit easier by creating a user interface. Since this is a script we only want to run once, we'll write it in the script editor. Input the following code. Now you can run this portion of script only by highlighting it and clicking the execute button. Maya creates a 400 pixel by 75 pixel empty window called ZACPWin. It's not much, but it's a start. Now let's create some controls. Add the following lines. This will give us two sliders and a button arranged in a column layout. Windows in Maya each need unique identities, assigned here to the variable ZACPWin. This means that if you forgot to close the window from the previous time you ran the script, Maya will detect the existing ZACPWin and return an error. Let's add a line of code to delete any old instances of this window if they currently exist. This will ensure that there is only ever one window and thus will have a unique identity. Now you should get a control panel that looks like this. Notice that the human and zombie sliders start at 10 and 3 and have a maximum of 20 and 5 respectively. However, if you try moving the sliders and clicking the generate button, nothing happens. We've scripted the generate button to run a procedure called ZACPGenerate. In order for the button to work, we'll need to create our ZACPGenerate procedure. A procedure is a block of script that you can execute manually by calling it. Start by declaring the procedure like this. We want this procedure to generate humans and zombies based on the values in our control panel. To start, let's grab those values and store them into our $numHumans and $numZombies variables. Instead of hard-coded values, our two variables are set to the values in our sliders. Now we just need to combine this with our scene initialization script. Copy and paste your old initialization script under these lines. Don't forget to remove your old hard-coded variable values. Now highlight the entire script and execute it. You can now generate the scene with interactive sliders and buttons instead of hard-coded values. As one final bit of cleanup, let's have this script delete any existing humans and zombies for us so we can start fresh each time we hit the generate button. Now if the size of the variable containing all the existing characters is anything but zero, Maya will erase those characters. As you can see from this entire simulation, mel scripting is a powerful way to interact with your scene. You may wonder what other commands exist in Maya for you to use. You can find a list of them, their flags, and examples of how to use them in the Maya technical documentation. Now you can try your hand at creating other scripted behaviors.